Beginning sitting in a comfortable seated position, whatever that is for you. And just with the hands in the lap, close the eyes and begin to become aware of the rhythm of your breath. And notice how the body's moving with the inhale and the exhale. Noticing if there's any resistance to the breath. And as you breathe and feel the body moving, become aware of your sit bones on the mat. And just let the weight of the body sink down through the hips. And down onto the mat. Just let yourself sink down. Feel rooted, feel grounded, feel supported. And feel the steadiness and the balance. And begin to breathe down into the belly. As you inhale, creating space. As you exhale, releasing any tension, releasing any tightness, whatever you've been carrying this morning, this week. Just let the inhale create space, bring the new. And let the exhale release whatever you no longer need to hold on to. And breathe right the way down into your root. Imagine that the breath can travel all the way down. Noticing any changes in the body with the breath. Relaxing the shoulders, relaxing the face, relaxing the legs. Breathing deep down to your root. Feeling your stability, your steadiness. We're going to tune in with Om Namo Gurudev Namo. I bow to the divine teacher within, I bow to the divine in all things. And just take a moment to know what that means for you. Connect with the divine teacher within. Connect with that sense of the divine in all things. Whatever we label it, good, bad, welcome, unwelcome, enjoyable, disaster. Just allow the divine to be in all things. Open yourself to that reality. And bringing the hands into prayer at the heart, just pressing the thumbs gently against the sternum. Taking a deep breath into the heart. And a deep inhale to chant. Om Namo Gurudev. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Deep inhale. Pause the breath. Pull up on the root lock, the pelvic floor. Feel the sensations. And gently exhale. Release the hands down. And just bring the hands to the front of the shins. We're just going to warm up the spine with a spinal flex. Inhaling forward, exhaling back. Moving at whatever pace feels comfortable for your body. Just warming yourself up with that gentle movement and breath. As you come forward, inhaling, opening the heart, opening the chest, receiving what's for you in this moment. As you exhale, pushing back, creating space between the vertebrae, releasing what's stuck, what's stagnant, creating movement and flow in the body. And as you move, become aware of your root. Become aware of that point where your body connects with the earth. And just notice how this gentle movement stimulates, energizes that part of the body. And as you breathe, imagine you're breathing all the way down to your root. When our root is balanced, when it's energized, we feel that sense of security, steadiness, we feel connected to the earth, and we can trust that everything we need will come to us. Not necessarily in the time that we want it to, might not be comfortable, but it will arrive in God's time. So if there's anything you know that you're fearful about, any area where you're not trusting that your needs are being met, become aware of that fear and just let it out on the exhale. Inhale, trust, faith. Exhale out that fear. And as you inhale into your heart center, find the compassion for yourself. That we do have fears, we do have worries. Human existence is not easy. It's not easy to surrender, to have faith in all things worldly. But just for now, just for this practice, we're going to practice inhaling faith, trust, compassion, exhaling the fear and the worry. Lovely, and inhale to center, deep inhale down to the root. Gently pausing the breath, pulling up the root lock, the pelvic floor. Exhaling, and then another deep inhale right the way down into the root. Energizing, balancing, pulling up on the root lock as you pause the breath. And as you exhale, just surrender, just let go, soften, release. back to yourself, noticing the sensations, noticing the emotions, the thoughts. And as you inhale, create space for everything that's there. Everything is welcome in this space. Deep inhale, full exhale. We're going to come up to our feet and come into archer pose.
So this is a very grounding
posture. We're going to bring the left foot forward, the right foot comes back at an angle. So before you do anything with the arms, just feel your base. And if you're feeling like that's not steady enough, you can't really sink into it, then just bring the feet a little further together or a little further apart. You really want to feel the strength of your foundation. So just try a few different options. And when you feel the strength of your foundation, you're going to bring the left arm up, the thumb straight in front of you. And you're going to focus on the thumb, and then you're going to bring the right arm forward, and as if you're pulling back a bow, you're going to pull that arm to the back. And as you do, the chest opens. You're still looking at your thumb, and the chest opens. So sinking down through the legs into your feet, front leg slightly bent, the back leg straight. If there's something you know you want to manifest, if there's something you know you want to generate, a focus, a goal, as you look at that thumb, think about that area of your life. And breathe. Feel the steadiness of your foundation, feel the support beneath you. Feel your strength, feel your focus. Breathe, focus, be steady and balanced. Use the power of the mind to direct your thoughts. Work with the body and the breath. Keep rooting down to your foundation. Feel your strength. Deep inhale, and as you exhale, lowering down, just shake out the arms, bring the right foot forward, left foot back, and again, just this side may be slightly different. You might want to have the feet further apart, closer together, just feel into that foundation, that strong foundation. And when you find it, when you feel planted, rooted, lifting the right arm up, feeling that focus, directing your thoughts and attention, and then bringing the left hand up, pull back the bow. This is the intention of action. Open the chest, open the heart center. Intention with heart, open heart, strong foundation. Direct your thoughts, feel the strength of your foundation, and breathe slowly. Feel rootedness. directing thoughts, believe in the strength of the body, the breath, the mind, when we connect with the support available to us, the support beneath us, the life force that moves through us, the power of the mind, the power of the heart, the power of our higher power, perfecting that. Posture, take a deep inhale, and you exhale, letting go of the intention, you've created it, now you can let it go. Coming all the way down onto your back, lying on your back. Pushing, just rock the hips from side to side, and then pushing the navel into the mat, feeling the core muscles turn on. Keep pushing the small of the back into the mat and feel the strength of the core, feel the support beneath you. And then with the feet together, you're just going to lift the toes off the mat, the feet off the mat, just about 6 inches. And breathe long and deep, so the body may shake. It helps to really stretch the legs, relax the shoulders. Feel your strength, feel the strength of the core, the I can. When the mind says, I can't hold it any longer, just keep breathing. You're doing great. Just a couple more seconds. And completely release down, relax the body. Feel the energy move. And then rolling onto your front. We're going to make fists with the hands and place them in our groin. And when you find that place where you can hold them without pain, any discomfort, then just lifting the legs again, lifting them just a few inches off the mat. And breathing steady. And imagine that you're breathing energy up from the earth. So as you breathe, imagine the energy of the earth coming into your navel, strengthening you, energizing you, giving you the energy to do this. Great. A deep inhale and then exhaling down, moving the hands, just placing the head to one side. Completely relax.
Let the front of the body soften. Feel the support beneath you. Feel that holding. Just in this moment, allow yourself to be held. Taking a deep inhale, a full exhale.
And then we're going to come up into bow pose. This is a bit tricky for you on my shoulder, but you're basically
grabbing your feet with your hands, and then lifting up. So I'm not going to hold it. Okay. And again, feeling the support beneath you. So feel that holding beneath you. Yeah.
Brilliant. So breathing. And if you feel like you can pull up, see what that's like. If you can pull up the feet, open up the chest, the heart. Lovely. Deep inhale. And release all the way down. Relax. And then pushing back into child's pose. Stretching the arms forward, breathing into the back. Feel that protection in this position. You're held, you're supported. Taking a deep inhale, a full exhale, and then tucking the toes under. And this again is not an easy one for me at the moment, but you're going to come up into downward dog. So just stretching out the legs, and then bringing the hands towards the feet. Just take a moment to clasp the elbows, sink forward, and it can feel nice just to rock from side to side. And then feeling your feet rooted to the mat, soften the knees, and gradually coming up. Bringing the head up last, rotating the shoulders, and planting the feet about hip distance apart, not a fart, apart, farts away, think. Lifting the arms out to either side. We're going to inhale, and then as we exhale, bring the right hand down to the left toe. Inhale up. And bring the left hand down to the right. So feeling the strength of your foundation. The knees are soft. You don't want to jam the knees back, the knees are soft. And imagine that you're literally surrendering to your foundation. You're surrendering to what holds you, what supports you, what keeps you up in life. Or you may like to think of it as giving thanks to that which supports you, that which holds you. Keeping the knees soft. One more time, both sides. And then we're going to bring the hands up. Link the thumbs together. Inhale, up and back. Again, with soft knees, exhale, coming down. So you can imagine as you inhale, it's like you're filling your aura with that energy of your root, that sense of security, trust, your needs being met.
And if you like to think in terms of colours as you inhale, you can imagine you're inhaling red. And that red is flowing through your aura. You're literally stroking red light up and down. One last time. And when you come up, you're going to drop the right arm down. And we're going to inhale over to the right side. And then come up, find that point of balance. Inhale over to the left. So if you think of Kundalini Yoga as a language, in this posture, as we're rooting down, feeling balanced and steady, we can see that we can be knocked off center, or we can flow to one side and the other and still maintain our balance. So it's okay that life takes us away from that very centered, balanced place, because we know how to come back. So if there's a place that you know you're feeling out of balance, and you know is out of balance, just think of it as we do this movement, and notice how you can bring yourself back into balance. And balance is not something that we can hold on to, it's just a point that we pass through, experience, as we then head off in another direction. Begin to play with how far over you can go. How far over can you go and maintain that steady foundation? That's good. And one more time, both sides. Lovely, and coming to center. We're going to inhale both arms up. And then bringing the hands down in prayer position, come all the way down into crow. Come back onto our bums. And bring the legs wide. And if you have long arms and open hips, you'll be able to hold on to your big toes as you do this. I don't find that easy. But if you can, then just press at the base of the big toe. Otherwise, we're going to inhale up, exhale down to the right. Inhale up, exhale down to the left. So as we move, you can think of opening up your hips. Any blocks, anything that you've been holding there that's holding you back, just allow it to move. Just let this movement open your hips and get energy, prana, moving through. Inhaling up, exhaling down.
And you can go at your own pace. Hinging from the hips.
Looks great.
It's said that we hold shame in our hips, and that can often be a block, can often be something that holds us back. So as we move and breathe, if you know there's something you're feeling ashamed of, those stories that we have about ourselves, I'm not good enough, I'm not worthy, I can't do it, I'm the problem. Whatever your version of that might be, just let the movement and the breath soften and release, move any blocks that come from those old stories. Lovely, and inhaling up. As you come up, just bring the hands behind the hips, bring the legs forward, give them a nice shake, open up the chest. And then we're going to just rock from side to side, get your sit bones nice and grounded, rooted. And wherever your hands feel comfortable, it might be your knees, your shins, your toes, we're going to inhale up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale up. It's getting to your back.
Just can't get anywhere.
That's fine. So just literally, you can just
do it from there.
Yeah.
So it. Your feet like this, is that okay?
Well, it's good to have them up. How does it feel when you do them up?
Really tough.
So start with them up then, but just don't. Start with them up, but just do a very. Small, it's absolutely fine if it's literally like this. So that's how I was, but what's good is if you start with the hips, then eventually you will be able to come down. But if you start with the back like that,
yeah.
Then you're never going to get down, because this is about opening the hips and stretching the life nerve, which goes right the way down.
My knees
then
lift as well.
That's okay.
Just
allow the knees to be soft and just let it be a very gentle rocking motion. It reads some, you know, all of our bodies different. And there's things that, you know, I have so little movement in. But the good thing is just to start small, really start and know that's okay. Even if it feels daft. They're still opening the hips. You know, this is still a hip opening. Yeah. So inhaling as you come up.
Keep your shoulders, back, and chest open, isn't it?
Yeah. And don't feel you have to be too far back. You can come forward. So. Try tipping a bit further forward, Jim. So just roll your sit bones, that's it. Great. Yeah. That's it. That's all you need to do. Just that very gentle. Great. And next time you come down, just let the head fall forward wherever you are, it might be. Literally just bringing the chin to the chest, or it might be letting the head come forward and the body down to the legs. Just breathe. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Coming up. Take a moment to bring the soles of the feet together and just bounce the knees, relax the shoulders. roughly, and then we're going to come into a shoulder stand.
So I'm just going to show this and then come out of it. But if you come up into it,
just with the knees low, so you're just literally rocking back, supporting your back with your hands, the knees are low. And then straighten the legs. If that feels too much, just keep the knees low. Lovely. And see if you can straighten the body. Don't move the head. Keep the neck straight. And then you're going to bring the legs over so that your toes, you're looking at your thighs and your toes are reaching down towards the floor.
That's it, so dropping legs towards you, lovely. That's it. And then separate legs out so the feet going towards the corner of each corner of the mat. Lovely. You're doing great. Yeah. So this is very good for the thyroid. It really stimulates the thyroid gland, which is right at the base of the throat. It's very good for the internal organs. Beautiful. If you want to stay in it, you can stay in it for a little longer. If you're ready to come back, bring the knees
down towards your head and then very gently just roll back. The head can come up. Bring the feet down to the mat and just relax back with bent knees, feet flat on the mat. And just notice the sensations in the body as you relax.
Feel the support beneath you. Allow yourself to soften and surrender to that holding. And then rolling over to one side, gently push yourself up into a sitting position. And then coming onto your knees, if that's really uncomfortable for you, it's fine to be cross-legged. You can always use a block to sit on if that makes it more comfortable. And we're going to bring the arms up above the head, clasp all of the fingers except for the forefinger. So that forefinger is acting like our antenna or aerial. And we're going to chant the mantra Sat Nam. And as we say Sat, we bring the navel in. And as we say Nam, we relax it out. So it's like this. Sat Nam. Sat Nam. And as you pull the navel in, pull up on the pelvic floor. So Sat Nam. Sat Nam. Sat Nam. Sat. Nam. And you can imagine that you're literally that security that the root generates is traveling up through the body into the universe, speaking
to your higher consciousness, speaking to your higher power. Satnam is truth of my identity. So stripping you back to the truth of your identity, the truth that your needs will be met if you can surrender control, direct yourself towards your higher power, towards your higher consciousness. Sat Nam, 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 Sat Nam. One last time, and then we're going to come forward. The hands are in prayer position. Come forward, bring the forehead to the ground, and just surrender in this position. Just surrender. Taking a deep full inhale, deep exhale, and as you inhale, coming back up to sitting, and sitting in a comfortable seated position, hands stretching out, the tips of the fingers touching the mat, and we're feeling that same rootedness, groundedness, balance. And we're going to inhale the arms all the way up to the backs of the hands touch and exhale down. And as you do this, imagine that you're again working this sense of security, trust, balance, groundedness through your whole being and through your aura. Feeling your connection to the earth through your root. Allowing that nourishing relationship to move through you, feed you, nourish, nurture you at every level. Hands come back down. Just let yourself feel the steadiness, the strength of that support beneath you. And then bringing the feet hip distance apart, we're going to come into crow. Feeling the balance, the strength. We're going to inhale up and exhale down. So seeing how all movement in this physical world comes from our roots, comes from our strong foundation. And when our root is balanced, steady, we're able to rise up, we're able to hold ourselves. And direct ourselves in whatever direction we choose. One more time, and as you come back down, bring the hands in front of you, and we finish with cat-cow, so inhaling the navel down as the hips and the head rise up, exhaling, pushing through the hands, through the arms, arching the back. Letting all that energy that you've generated move through the body. And get in touch with that wave of motion that starts at your root, the very tip of your tailbone, and travels right the way up your spine to your head. And let the head, the mind, be fed by your root. Let the energy come from there. Let it reassure your mind that all is well. Your foundation is strong. You're connected. Your needs will be met. Let the head be led by the wave that starts at the root. Coming to a neutral position, take a deep inhale, a deep exhale, and then come all the way onto your back for final relaxation. So whatever position feels comfortable, whether it's having your knees bent, supporting the lower back, and the legs straight. yourself soften. Let the weight of the body sink down. Surrender whatever you're ready to let go of. Let yourself be held. Let yourself be healed. Relax the face, relax the jaw, soften the throat and the neck, relax the shoulders, let the arms be heavy, let the belly be soft. Release the hips and let the weight of the hips sink down. Relax the back, relax the legs. Soften the knees and the area behind. Relax the feet. Soften, relax. Let yourself be held. Becoming aware of the very gentle movement of the breath. Notice how your body moves on the inhale, moves on the exhale. And allow the breath to deepen. Breathing down into your belly. Breathing down into your root. And gently, ever so gently, bring some movement to your fingers. Some movement to your toes. Relax. when you're ready, rotating the wrists, rotating the ankles. And on an inhale, stretching the arms all the way over the head. Have a lovely stretch through the body. And then bringing the arms down, bring the knees into the chest. Gently rocking from side to side. Just feel that sense of holding, cradling yourself. Just let that rocking comfort, reassure. And then rubbing the hands, the palms, and the soles of the feet together. Stimulate all of those nerve endings. You can either rock and roll up to sitting or roll over to one side and then push yourself gently up. And come finding that balance, that steadiness. Bring the hands into prayer at the heart. Bow the head to the heart. Breathing down into your root. And repeating after me, may I be happy and healthy, peaceful and prosperous. May you be happy and healthy, peaceful and prosperous.
May you be happy and healthy, peaceful and prosperous.
May all beings be happy and healthy, peaceful and prosperous.
May all beings be happy and healthy, peaceful and prosperous.
And we'll finish with three satnams, taking a deep inhale and a deep exhale. And then a deep inhale to chant.
Sa.
Thank you.